And down we go. And then once, down again.
You must gather your party before venturing.
Come on, guys. Chunk. Oh my god.
I'm here to help.
This game. Alright. Well, Corwin, we're here. We're ready. Complete your preparations. Once you start marching north, there will be no coming back. Oh yeah, I'm as ready as I want to be.
Alright. I'll see you on the morrow. Word is your friend Imoen's mostly recovered from the Crusader poison, if you want to speak with her. Just remember, once you go up to your room, I'll leave to begin preparing for the journey. You won't get another chance to head out into the city.
Okay, we're going. Bye. Onward to adventure. And probable TPKs, rage, and fireballs. Alright, so what, do I just need to sleep?
So this is the Slayer of Sarevok, the hero of Baldur's Gate. How pleased I am to make your acquaintance.
I would recognize that voice absolutely anywhere. This is Irenicus! As I'm sure I will be yours once you tell me how you got in here.
If it is security you desire, it would be prudent to reconsider your sleeping arrangements. I suspect the palace's weaknesses have become all too apparent to you of late. Strange. There lies within you barely a spark of divine consciousness, yet you bested your brother in blood. How? What is it that drove you to victory where so many others fell in defeat?
The teachings of my foster father Gorion saw me through.
Gorion. His death was the first step of your current journey, was it not? I wonder what wisdom did he impart that left such an impression?
He made certain I knew what I needed to know to survive.
Interesting. We will see if that is enough to bear you through the trials ahead. You do not see it yet, but another crossroads in your journey lies before you. One you will reach sooner than you think. The path you choose is of interest to me. Your path could lead in many directions. You waver, unsure whether to claim credit for your deeds or to brush them aside. I can offer you clarity. But we can speak more of this in time, when I am certain that you are the one I seek.
Who are you? What do you want?
Suffice it to say that I am a man who has lost much, but would regain some measure of what was taken from me. That is all you need know. I am not here to act, not yet. I am here to evaluate. Are you worthy? Is what you carry within enough? Are you strong enough to overcome the challenges you shall soon face? Only the passage of time will provide us answers. I'm curious to see how this plays out. I will be watching.
Fucking. Alright, I can appreciate.
Oh, you're back. Sorry if I don't seem excited to see you. Poison really takes a toll.
What's that man in the hood doing here?
You don't know him? He said he was a friend of yours. We've known some pretty strange characters, so I didn't think it was weird to have someone pop in looking for you.
I didn't know who he was. He's certainly no friend of mine.
Forget about him. We need to talk about your going to battle the Crusade. I know you think you have to do this, but I am telling you, you don't. Not only do you not have to do it, you shouldn't. I'm healing, but you need to heal too. Not just from fighting Sarevok. Those are just cuts and scars. But in coming to terms with, you know, what you are. Let someone else take care of the Shining Lady. Please.
Well, would that I could, but she's forced my hand.
I knew you'd say that. I'm sorry. I can't go with you.
I'd not have had you anyways. You'd only slow me down. I don't want you to. You'll be safer here.
Well, so would you, silly. But that doesn't matter, does it? I know that look in your eyes. I'm just wasting my breath. Promise me you'll be careful, all right? I don't know what I'd do if... We've just lost too many people, you know? I'm gonna leave now. Take care of yourself.
I'll see you in Baldur's Gate 2, M.O.N. I am now, Ski.
You can't tell Daddy, Duke Silvershield, about this.
About what?
I've joined the Flaming Fist!
No, you haven't.
No, really, I have. Not under my name, of course. Daddy would never allow it. But I'm in it now! Life as a noble is boring and stupid. I want to do something great with my life. And also get out of this dirty old city. And maybe meet some handsome soldiers. So, I'm going north with you.
Well, that's something.
Alright, go back to sleep. I'll see you in... Oh, I guess you don't really have time to sleep now. I'll see you soon. Remember, whatever you do, don't tell Daddy about this.
I'm totally telling your father about this if given the opportunity. Or we're just going back to bed. Damn it. Chunk would have totally, like, wall ran all the way down and told her father about it.
Here is the hero, ready, get ready to go.
I'm here to help.
The early bird catches the evil worm. Isn't that right, Boo?
Oh, Minsk. Sounds like some miniature giant space hamster. Oh my god.
Dragonspear Castle. The sooner we shall learn whether they father spawned Caelar, as well as the end Sarevok.
I'm here to help.
Oh my god. Man, the writing in this is, like, this isn't bad. Like, I don't know, like, unless it gets, like, just terrible later in. I don't know what everybody was whining about. And idiots. So do I just, I can't imagine I just leave. Is the Duke in here? Can I tell him?
Ah, it's a hero of our lives.
I hope you slept well. You have a long road ahead.
Our prayers and hopes go with you. Your help, I'm sure we'll be able to stop the crusade before it grows any stronger.
The Flaming Fist travels with you under the command of Captain Corbin and Corporal Duncan. I'm sorry that Duke Elton could not be present, but the ongoing crisis has called his attention elsewhere. Is there anything else you need before you depart?
What route will we take to Dragonspear Castle? You have to travel by Major Rose. The contingent is too large to move swiftly over land. You cross the winding water at Coastway Crossing, then it's a straight march to Dragonspear.
Is there anything else?
I guess not.
May the gods look upon you with favor.
May Timora smile on you, Chunk. If anyone can end this threat to the city, it is
you.
You
better get moving, unless there was something else.
I actually had one more thing to speak to you about, privately. It's a family matter.
I guess. Skis joins the Flaming Fist and plans to journey north with you.
If you already know, then there's nothing more to say.
Just this, which I offer with all sincerity. I appreciate your coming to tell me of my daughter, though I knew it already. Please accept this ring as a token of my gratitude. When her brother died, Ski changed. She got wilder, pushed me away. I am hopeful this experience will help change her priorities. One other thing. Few of those traveling with you will know Ski's true identity. She is to receive no special treatment from the Flaming Fist. You, however, know exactly who she is. I expect my daughter return to me alive and unharmed. I am understood, I trust. Good. Speak with Captain Corwin by the main doors and be on your guard. The trip north will likely hold dangers besides the crusade.
Alright. That was one thick fucking accent right there. The guards ring, plus two AC, plus two saving throws. This is actually a really good ring. Alright, well, naturally, Dinah here is not getting it. Dinah here gets nothing except damage as soon as it becomes available for her. Where'd that ring go? There it is. Can you equip it? I don't think anybody's actually going to be able to equip this. Yeah. Which is a shame, what could but I do to help? Eventualities.
I'm here to help.
All right, where's Corwin at? I assume she's probably waiting for us outside.
Gather your party before venturing.
Look at all the people come to wish us good fortune in our travels, Boo.
Grab Viconia here. All right. I see her. Iconia, is that you? You're a drow. I belong to no man, Fog, and certainly not you. Well met, Chunk. It's been a while. I was sorry you left after dealing with Korlas. I attended a business of a personal nature. More than that, you need not know. You're still my friend, Viconia. I'd like to know what's happening in your life.
Does not learn thy lesson by now? Viconia keeps her secrets close as her faith dictates.
Go fuck yourself, Dinah here. I'm gonna feed you to wolves.
We're here for the same reason. The council put the world out looking for those ready to fight against this Caelar, and we're always ready for a fight.
Yeah, you deserve better companions than this, Viconia. Join me!
Wait a minute. Wait one fell Delkin minute. I don't care who you are. Don't care if you're Lord the Hells 1 through 9. You're not taking our cleric away from us.
I'm taking your cleric! I told you before, Fog, I belong to no one.
Oh, that cheek. I'll have your hide, you treacherous cow!
I think not. This is the hero of Baldur's Gate, remember? And as you remember that, recall what happened to Sarevok. Come. Let us leave this Iblith dwarf to wallow in his own filth.
I just can't hear anyone but fucking Azula from Avatar The Last Airbender in her voice. Like, it was... Oh my god.
Look to my example.
I understand. Please tell Boo that I'll try to rein the others and myself in a bit going forward. Many thanks. You've made Boo very happy. Don't worry, Minsk. Where are we at? We're at dislike. That's okay. We'll just donate to a temple at some point and we'll be good. Alright! The cleric returns! And I think we have a better ring for her now. She has, I think, a plus one. Oh no, that's extra memorization. Crap! What is she wearing? Legacy of the Masters. Because I think it's her... Is it... Cloak of Protection? Oh, she's got a Cloak of Protection on. That'll do it. See you. Another magic. What is he wearing that's giving him AC? Is it his helm? No. Amulet? Ah, here we go. Alright, so Chung, or Minsk actually will get an upgrade out of this. Nice! Okay, so who else do we have? Safana, Belgrim, nobody I really care about. I know I saw her.
Alright, Corwin.
I'm gonna miss you so much, Roma. Oh, she's got a kid! Jesus. Is that the hero? Oh my god, we could be a dick, but I won't. Who is this delightful child, Captain Corwin? I'm not a child, I'm 5. Believe me, Zara, the thought has occurred to me. Get some little half-dwarves running around out here. I stand corrected. You killed Sarevok. Are you gonna kill Caelar too? I'm hoping it won't come to that. Just like you? And your mother's a tough lady, and you're lucky to have her. Sometimes, when she's here... I know, I just miss you when you go, is all.
I know. I miss you too. Now give me a hug and go to your grandfather. Are you ready to leave the city?
I'm ready. Is this gonna turn to shit? Like, is violence gonna occur? No, alright, these are happy crowds, okay. Everybody cheering. Like, this is pretty neat to see this in the Infinity Engine. Uh-oh. What are you doing? Cheering? Cheering for a sibling of Sarevok? That's what they are. They found Sarevok's journal. It reveals the truth. But the Council of Four wants to keep it a secret. Is that true, Chunk? Are you a child of Ball? You question the hero of Baldur's Gate? I can handle this, Captain Corwin. This is a bad idea. You're probably right! Oh, I love it. So what can we do? We can completely sidestep what he said, or we can tell them that we are a Ball spawn. And your only shield against what comes, your only sword, only one with the divine coursing through their veins that can hope to thwart the child of a god, and only one that can end the threat of Caelar Argent. Now stand aside lest you feel my wrath. Okay, no. Yeah, you're probably right, this is a bad idea. So right out of town, you filthy ball lickers, and don't ever come back. Get it? Ball lickers? Because ball sounds like testicles, guys. Oh. Maturity.
Captain Shale Corwin and her aide, Corporal Bence Duncan, maintain order in the caravan from Baldur's Gate. Some who joined the expedition are unaccustomed to flaming fist discipline. Hard lessons are learned in the early days of the march north. The journey is slowed by the Crusade's victims. A multitude of broken, haunted men and women clog the coast way. When asked, they speak of fields set aflame, granaries ransacked, and family conscripted by the Crusade. Yet many characterize these hardships as necessary sacrifices in pursuit of a greater good. A strange acceptance, even admiration of Caelar Argent is disconcertingly common in those she has wronged. Some proclaim the Shining Lady a prophet, doing the work of not one but all faiths, all gods. Is it possible Caelar Argent's cause is a righteous one? Or is she engaged in a great deception to further her own agenda, as Sarevok once did?
Okay. I'm curious to find out.
And what of your goals?
Many souls were lost during the Dragonspear Wars. I will see justice done and restore them to the light.
Yes, quite honorable. But what makes you think yourself capable of achieving this, Caelar Argent?
You dare befoul my person with your magics?
Blood is something to behold, not fear. Your divine heritage radiates from you. From which of your parents, mother or father?
Enough of these games, and enough of your questions! Heffernan, get this mage out of my sight!
At once, my lady. We will have words about this, Scarred One.
Perhaps.
Fucking Irenicus is doing what Irenicus does.
I am growing concerned with things thou hast done and others thou hast allowed. There is a line twixt good and evil, and thou art perilously close to crossing it.
Yes, thank you, Dinah here. I will attempt to change, just be patient with me. Ideally, I will change, and you'll get to see that before the wolves tear you apart, but I'm doubtful. There's a darkness within thee, be watchful, and at that point, Chunk begins ignoring her. Alright. It's 10 of 6, so I think I'm gonna go ahead and call this here.